Last few classes we have seen the importance of fat soluble vitamins, and we have seen in detail about vitamin A, D, E and K, and what are their roles in the body and how they are got from the dietary sources and other sources, and what are the effects of excess consumption and deficient consumption of these vitamins. Now let us move on to the water soluble vitamins. These are also vitamins, but they are soluble in water and the excess will not be retained in the body. So water soluble vitamins generally dissolve in water. They get readily excreted, so no storage of water soluble vitamin occurs. Then they are subjected to cooking losses. Very easily they are lost during the process of cooking. Then they function as coenzymes in many metabolic reactions and participate in energy metabolism. Then 50% to 90% of B vitamins are absorbed. So generally there is no deficiency. If you don't consume a balanced diet, then only the deficiency of B vitamins occur. Then marginal deficiency is more common. So the first vitamin among the water soluble vitamins is the thiamine. So this was the first vitamin that the researchers discovered. Therefore it is named as vitamin B1. So thiamine plays a vital role in the transmission of nerve impulses by keeping the nerves healthy. And it also allows the body to break down alcohol and metabolize carbohydrates and amino acids. So in the metabolism of carbohydrates and proteins, thiamine plays a very important role in the form of coenzyme. The food sources of thiamine: you have legumes as very good sources, beef and pork, then brewer's yeast, whole grain breads, cereals, oatmeal, then enriched pasta, rice bran, wheat germ, milk, nuts and seeds, and oranges. So all the grains which are eaten along with the outer cover or seed cover, they have good thiamine present in the food, because the thiamine is present in the outer layers of the grains. So when we consume highly polished rice, we are losing the thiamine in the rice. Therefore deficiency may occur. So you can see the rich sources of thiamine. This can be consumed in your diet to reduce the thiamine deficiency. Now deficiency of thiamine, it occurs whenever the polished rice becomes the staple food of people. So people generally like rice in a very white form. So when it is in the form along with the bran, it is very difficult to consume for the people. Therefore wherever polished rice is consumed, then the thiamine deficiency occurs. So symptoms of thiamine deficiency is known as beriberi, and it can result from inadequate intake of thiamine or excessive loss of thiamine from the body. So and there is an increased requirement of thiamine, so whenever there are anti-thiamine factors present in the food, especially the consumption of fish has an anti-thiamine factor, therefore thiamine is not absorbed. Some of the people are at higher risk for thiamine deficiency, including the chronic alcoholics, then patients who receive intravenous feeding for more than 7 days without any supplements. When they are just given the dextrose into the body, they become deficient of thiamine. And people who undergo the dialysis, they also suffer from the thiamine deficiency. Now what is the symptom of deficiency of thiamine? Beriberi can be divided into 3 subtypes. One is called as dry beriberi, where the neuromuscular complications occur, especially for the peripheral neuropathy, or all the peripheral neurons are affected and there is weakness. Then wet beriberi is the second type, where the cardiovascular system is involved and complications such as heart failure occur. There is edema in the body of the individual. So this is the wet beriberi. And the third type of beriberi is the cerebral beriberi, so where the brain is involved or the central nervous system is involved, and it has complications like Wernicke encephalopathy, where there are abnormal eye movements. Then there are gait abnormalities. The person is not able to walk according to the right way he wants to walk. Then mental dysfunction, etc. Then there is Korsakoff's psychosis, where the individual suffers from apathy. There is lack of interest in the surroundings, confusion, then there is severe memory deficit or amnesia. So this is how the wet and dry beriberi look like. You can see in the dry beriberi, the person is not able to walk and he has to take the help of crutches because the peripheral nerves are affected. Whereas in the wet beriberi, there is so much of edema, you can see the pitting when it is pressed for a few seconds. Now, excess intake of vitamin B1 or thiamine, it is generally considered safe and non-toxic. So even when you give high doses, because excess is excreted. But doses more than 100 milligrams may cause drowsiness and muscle relaxation. So some people report a burning sensation when the thiamine is received via injection. So now, recommended dietary allowance of thiamine. Thiamine is a vitamin which is related to the energy metabolism. Therefore, the requirement of thiamine depends upon the energy intake. So every 1000 kilocalories of the energy is related to the intake of thiamine. So according to that, the recommendation of 1.1 milligrams per day for women is recommended and 1.2 milligrams for men, and daily value of on an average should be 1.5 milligrams. So most of us exceed RDA in our diet, except that low income people and older people may barely meet the needs because the consumption of the staple food is more compared to the other foods in their diet. I mean, they do not take the proper balanced diet. So, and people who take highly processed and unenriched foods, sugar, fat and alcohol also undergo a deficiency of thiamine. And surplus is rapidly lost in urine, non-toxic and no upper level. Now, alcohol and thiamine. Why alcoholics are affected by thiamine deficiency? So they are at great risk because the absorption and use of thiamine is profoundly diminished when alcohol is consumed, or the excretion is increased by the alcohol consumption. That is why the alcoholics undergo deficiency of vitamin B1. Along with alcohol, they also consume very low or poor diet and very little is stored in the body. So alcoholic binge for 1 to 2 weeks. If person continuously consumes alcohol for 1 to 2 weeks in large quantities, he will definitely result in deficiency. This is a small vitamin which is required in very small quantity, that is 1.1 milligram per day, but it causes so much of discomfort in the body and causes so many drastic symptoms involving the nervous system and the cardiovascular system, making the person very weak, the cerebral beriberi, which makes the brain weak, and the person has symptoms of confusion, apathy and amnesia. Therefore, it is a very important nutrient which has to be included in the diet by giving the proper food sources. Thank you.